All right, as our man Austin Okonak, man, filling us in with what has happened with the elections into the National Sports Federation's elections across board today. A lot of drama, and we'll fill you in with what's been happening as the days goes by. A lot of things will still happen, and we'll let you know. All right, let's move on the show. Cosmos, this is good. This is good coming for Nigerian football. The NFF are glad to announce that salaries have been paid. A lot of coaches have been looked into. A lot of the handlers of our national teams have been looked into. Some of these guys that were also paid were not even hired by this current dispensation. So some sort of good news, you know, house cleaning, if you ask me. But it's good that, you know, the Nigerian Football Federation can take care of whichever way you want to look it. It's good news coming today.
Yeah, pretty much. Of course, and that was the essence of the partnership that they had with an oil and gas company about a month or two ago. And yes, the essence was to pay a backlog of salaries of coaches.
Ensure that coaches are not old.
Both the ones that are alive and the ones they have to pay posthumously.
Even this one that were not hired.
Exactly, these ones that weren't hired as well. But then it's in the book, so they have to pay them. I mean, some are old as far back as 2004-05, so and that's about 2-3 balls back. So
it's good.
It's a good one because it actually gives them a clear head to say that okay, yes, we have some other things to do and you know, move on.
All right, let's quickly talk about Sunshine Stars. Mm-hmm. They're in the news. They've been banished to Ijebu-Ode. They've 1 million naira fine.
Yep.
And still under consideration. Some of those matches, you know, it may be played with closed doors. Mm. And their goalkeeper has been handed a 12-man ban.
That was surprising.
All coming from that game against Plateau United. The disruptive behavior of the fans on that day.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, that's what some of us have been saying, that when a team misbehaves at home, I mean, you try as much as possible to hit them hard. You know, not tell them, okay, not find them 1 million naira, 3 million naira that will be taken away from their sponsorship money anyway that you're supposed to remit
back to them. And the players will be the ones to suffer for it
and all that. I mean, Sunshine Stars, if you remember, 2 seasons ago, and that was what actually disrupted them from... you know, actually,
their progress.
They were banned to Lagos, and of course, you know what happened after. Of course, some of us wanted to see them play in Lagos and all that. But then, you know, it has happened to Sunshine Stars. I mean, in a week, they lost their coach, and you know, of course, they are banned to Ijebu Ode.
Even though you don't like to be put on the spot, but that's why you're on the other side.
Yeah,
is this enough? Should we still go to the point where we say we're taking 3 points, we're deducting this, we're doing this, should we, or this is just enough?
Let me give you an example. In the late 80s, when there was so much hooliganism happening in the English league, the league body at the time had to sit down and take some very, very tough decision against teams. Seems like Millwall suffered for it as well. And that was why when they came in 1992 and formed the Premier League, they tried as much as possible to put down some rules and regulation. And today the Premier League is better for it. I say that you try as much as possible to bring order to the league. Now the LMC are trying to do that. And for me, if there is issues in any match, the LMC should hit any team hard. 3 point deduction is even very small for me.
Oh, okay.
So any team hard.
You have answered me. All right, we need to move on. We're on the home stretch now. A few minutes to the end of the program, but let's quickly tell you some of the things we'll quickly want to talk about. Cheick Tiote,
yep.
His friends and a lot of people in China are mourning him. Just about a little over a week,
okay.
Slumped in training. And, you know, tributes, Cipriore in, some of his colleagues, you know, some of his teammates in the Elephants, still in shock.
Mm.
They're paying their tributes.
Yeah, paying the tribute. I mean, this Czech Tirtis death reminds me of the time when Mark Vivien Fouet died in that FIFA Confederations Cup in 2003. At that time.
Against France?
Against Colombia the semifinals.
But
immediately they played the finals, and you could see that both sides, both the French side and, of course, the Cameroonian
should
side,
respect.
Should respect and all that. And everybody
and
should
this
respect
is similar,
well.
Similar, I mean, to that.
Similar to that. Right. And it's a very sad one, but then we can only show our respect. And yes, you can see some of his teammates still trying to
this Papi Cisse.
Yeah, Papi Cisse, former Newcastle player, actually played with him in Newcastle.
They were friends.
They were good friends as well. Right. So it's a very, very sad one. And he's the one standing there, trying as much as possible, saying some things. And
had to fight the tears. It's not easy.
If anybody told him
he was going
to
be doing this,
at some point he couldn't just talk. I saw the video. He couldn't just talk.
All right.
It's a very sad one, but then what can we do?
We hope his family will be able to, God will grant them the fortitude to bear the loss.
Exactly.
All right, let's really move on. Let's talk about Cristiano Ronaldo. At some point, you always knew this was going to happen.
Yeah.
Where there has been suspicion of tax evasion and all of those things. But now, Spanish prosecutors are going after Cristiano Ronaldo, that he avoided paying huge amounts.
Over 30 million euros. And some people, the talks on the social media is that competitions between Messi and Ronaldo, even to the point of tax evasion. And it's something that hasn't been proven yet.
But another thing a lot of people are angry with is these players earn huge amounts of money, and whoever is handling their books should be able to ensure. I mean, these guys will pay this money without even blinking.
Yeah.
And so it shouldn't happen. But I'm hoping all of this will not affect Cristiano Ronaldo as he goes to the FIFA Confederations
Cup.
As the new season begins in Spain, all of these issues will be sorted.
Yeah.
You can't take it for granted that he won't go to jail because he's the first offender. Spanish rules guarantee that. That's even if he's found guilty. All right, let's talk about Antoine Griezmann still staying in Spain. 1 year contract extension for him. He stays with Atletico because Atletico will not be able to buy players. And I guess it's a sensible decision for the club.
Very sensible decision for the club. I mean, he was one of their best.
And it's a
players.
Win-win for both
because
Griezmann will probably have the opportunity to have his the clause in his contract lowered.
Exactly.
So if he plays for them a year, it's going to be easier for any club who wants to get his services. So you're not going to be hearing $100 million.
That's the essence of this. I mean, Griezmann is actually thinking next season. Now he knows that Atletico Madrid are in a very dire strait situation right now, where they cannot
he loves the club, can't just leave them.
He can't just leave them, and of course they cannot be able to sell any of their players because of that ban from CAS and of course FIFA. So it's a good one for him, good one for the club, and let's see how it goes. And hopefully it's going to help them next season scoring them good goals, because he didn't particularly score much goals for Atletico Madrid this season.
All right, let's talk about Claudio Ranieri.
Yep.
He's back in the news. He told us that look, I want to get to management as soon. I want to get back to management as soon as possible. Claudio Ranieri now in France. He's going to be coaching Nantes, club that Samson Seasia played for at some point in his career. I think it's a good one.
And they have to fight relegation. It's coming back to the French League One, I think, for the first time in about 3 years or so, because he actually coached Monaco at some point. Brought him out of League Two to League One, and I've got made them steady and all that. He's coming back. But then, in the ask yourself, is it for lack of offers from good clubs? Why is he going to Nantes?
Why not stay in England?
Exactly. Why not stay in England? Well, let's just say, let's see whether he's going to do a Leicester at North. I do not think so, though. Although Montpellier did that, but I do not think so.
All right, Montpellier did it, and just to put facts into it, our own John Otaka was there when Montpellier did that. And ever since they've not been able to. Ever since then, they've not been able to replicate that. And we'll see what happens with that. Claudio Ranieri, maybe lightning will strike
twice.
In the same place, twice. We'll see. We'll see about that. All right, that's how we have to wrap up the show today. We hope that you've enjoyed what we've been able to do. Cosmos, I want to thank you for
thank you so much.
Braving the odds in spite of the rain and everything. Thank you very much. Austin was here with us earlier. I want to say a big thank you to you as well for staying tuned and for enjoying today's package. Let's do this again tomorrow. We have more time on our hands and we'll take you on a trip across the money spinning world of sports. We'll do this again tomorrow. Bye bye now.